Hey guys, I'm back with my brother. Let's get into this.
What he said.
Alright, but in all seriousness, hey guys, what's up? I'm back, and this is my brother Sawyer, and we are going to be doing a sort of review series. We watch a lot of movies, and we talk about them a lot, and I feel like we can voice our opinion and get it out there for you guys for some, just for some laughs or whatever. I don't know. But yeah, so we're calling this Raunchy Reviews. The first movie that we watched was The Spirit, and honestly, let's just get into it. First thing to talk about is the characters. There is The Spirit, the main guy, Octopus, who is played by Samuel Jackson, Samurai Jackson. there's Scarlett Johansson, that one chick from Ghost Rider, whatever her name is, who plays Sans Serif, who is actually in, I think she's in the comics, when I read it off the Wikipedia.
Well.
And, that one chick, the doctor chick, and then the commissioner. I honestly have no clue what their names are. They say the names, I just didn't bother to remember them, I think.
Yeah.
But yeah, so definitely the standout one is Samuel Jackson.
He gives an all-out performance,
yeah,
for how bad and weird the script is. He tries to make it work. Without the actors giving it their all in this movie, I don't think it would have been anywhere close to how good it is. It's not really a good movie, but it does make
for sure
you laugh a little bit.
That covers it on the mark. The plot of this movie is very hard to understand, I think. Because I think there's three different plots going on in this movie, honestly. What's the first plot?
The first plot is pretty much... So the first plot is him trying to find the octopus and get him to, like, just take him down and get him into justice or whatever. Well, you can't really kill him because both of them are immortal.
Yeah, they both have weird, like, superpowers that they never fully describe, other than they just can't die.
Yeah, they both get damaged, but they just heal in, like, a day or whatever. I don't know, it's hard to explain how it works.
Yeah.
Because it's never explained in the movie.
Yeah, and then the next plot is with Sans Serif and her, and like him like finding out that, right?
Yeah.
And
it's like him trying to find out how, or like what his powers are and how he got them.
Yeah, yeah. And then I guess the third plot is, I guess, killing the octopus.
I mean, that's how it resolves.
Like, I don't know. Yeah, because like that's like the whole plot of the movie, and like it's just a really weird movie, guys. The filmmaking aspects, honestly, it has that the Sin City, kind of like a 300,
kind of black and white, but it's almost like it's just
it's muted,
desaturated.
Yeah, and he picks out like what colors he wants. So like, I gotta say, like, the shots that he can come up with in his head of Frank Miller are really creative. Like the one shot where like he punches the ground and then like the mud like spurts up into the camera. He's like a lot of shots like that where like something like covers up the camera because
or, like
someone's
in one
moving.
Part, like soldier or like SWAT guy runs over the camera and
mm-hmm.
his footprint like stays on the camera.
Some really cool imagery, I guess. So I guess like the movie continuity wise and the filmmaking aspects sort of makes sense. Story wise, it's a little all over the place, I'm gonna be honest. So just some things that we put down. He's a really weird fetish with the city.
At first it's like he thinks it's like a girlfriend or whatever, but then he like treats it almost like a mother later on.
Yeah, like he talks like,
or like a protector.
Yeah, like a motherly protector figure. Seeing the shadows when he's like fighting and you see like him beating up a person with shadows is really cool.
They introduce the villains and Sans Serif kind of out of nowhere. Like, it just goes into a scene with the spirit's just with a police officer, or whatever, and they find one dude just like on a, like in water or on like a, just in a bunch of mud pretty much.
Yeah, they really don't like describe where this place is.
Yeah, it's just a weird muddy swamp pretty much.
Like right outside the city? I don't know where. It's Frank Miller.
Yeah. So they find this one guy there, and then he just goes on about like how he got there, and it's him just in the water with Sans Serif, who is the girl who the spirit is in love with, kind of.
Yeah.
I don't know, he likes every girl he meets, but he's in love with this girl-ish.
It was like the first girl he loved when he was a kid or whatever, a teenager.
Yeah, it was like his childhood romance.
Yeah, that fell off because what happened exactly? Like,
just stop.
I'm so confused. Let me start that again.
Okay, no, you won't get it. So there was a police officer who was related to Sans Serif, and he was shot, and because he kind of protected the spirit's uncle when he was younger, in like a tussle between one guy and the spirit's uncle, the police officer got shot, and then the dude runs away, and the spirit's uncle just doesn't know what to do, so he just shoots himself. And the girl stumbles across that scene like a couple minutes before the spirit gets there, but well, this is when he was a kid.
Yeah, so it's before honestly, he's the spirit. I forgot his name.
They don't really go over it a lot, so yeah.
No, but like honestly, and then she like a cameraman and like a dude go up to her, and they're like, tell us something about what you saw, and then she like goes off and like, I hate cops, but it's like, I feel like it was kind of badly acted.
I don't even know why she hates cops at that point. There's no real reason.
Wait, yeah, I have no clue, because like, isn't her dad or her uncle the cop?
The cop was just doing his job. And
wait, so she hates cops because they would die in service, you know, doing their duty.
Well, I mean, I don't get why she hates cops, because, you know, they were just doing their job, you know. He just died in the line of service, kind of, but not really, because he just died by accident because he was walking down the street at the wrong time.
Yeah, I definitely feel like there wasn't like a fully, I don't think Frank Miller fully fleshed out the story. He just wanted to make it. I don't know. Listen, I like Frank Miller. I like Batman Return or The Dark Knight Returns, and that gives him a plus in my book, but this is wacky.
So, Samuel L. Jackson has a lot of really odd dialogue in this movie. He'll just be on, like, at one point he throws a head at the spirit and yells, heads up.
Like, what do you even say about that? Like,
or, I don't know the context, but at another point he's like, I don't like eggs on my face. Not a glob.
And it makes no sense because, like, there was no mention of eggs before that.
Yeah, he just mentioned it.
I feel like he just said something and then Frank Miller was like, yes, film that.
Or like, come on, toilets are always funny.
I don't...
When he smashes a toilet over his head. That's just some odd dialogue in it.
It is really awkward. And then, like, the part where he's just, like, punching Sam Jackson in the water. Just like repeatedly and then stops.
Yeah, I counted 18 punches. Then he stops. Then he goes in for like probably 10 or so more. Then the octopus just disappears from his hands.
Yeah, yeah.
And then pops up behind him, like going over each of his shoulders at a time.
They do the last airbender thing where like Aang is like right behind that dude. You know, in the M. Night Shyamalan movie?
No, I know what you're talking about, but I don't know what you're talking about. I know the movie, but no clue what you're talking about.
It's such a stupid scene, and I thought it was stupid in this, too. I'm like, you can totally see him if you have peripherals. So, another weird thing that happens in this is, like, Sans Serif, the the love interest or not, I don't even know. Evil love interest, I'll say that.
The girl who likes shiny things.
Yes, that girl. She, in one scene, is like talking to these people and then sits on a printer, prints out a picture of her butt, and later the spirit is in like the crime scene where she was, and he finds the photo of her ass, and then proceeds to show people around the city her ass, saying, "Have you seen this woman? Who does that?" And then it gets worse. He shows it to some doormen, and then one of the doormen is a midget, and he shows it to him, and of course he knows her because he knows asses because he's at their eye level. Like, it's such a wacky joke.
Yeah. Another weird thing. They dress Sam Jackson up a little bit in this movie. Like, in one point he's wearing a samurai outfit, like, and he has mutton chops that, like, he plays with.
He's a
like
Wolverine.
They're
clearly
just glued on.
Like, yeah, you could see that they're just prosthetics.
Yeah, and another weird costume that he wears is a Nazi uniform, because he's a Nazi, I guess.
I don't know, man.
I don't know. In the end of the movie, or near the end of the movie, he has a whole Nazi room set up with swastikas everywhere. Tells his big master plan and what all happened, and it's, yeah.
It was something else. And then there's also this one scene with Sam Jackson where, so he has these henchmen that is all just one person that's just cloned a bunch of times on a green screen, clearly. Mm-hmm. But I mean, it's funny, and it works for henchmen. And he creates this one, and he's just like sitting around a table like this.
Sam Jackson is just like sitting at a table. He's just watching a head on a foot just bounce around, and then Scarlett Johansson walks up behind him and is like, or no, and he's like, "Isn't that just plain damn weird?" And she's like, "Yeah, just plain damn weird."
Just plain damn weird. Like, just the wackiest stuff ever.
Yeah.
So, what are your final thoughts on this movie?
I definitely, if you're gonna watch it, don't go into it seriously. Like, go into it expecting to laugh, and not like it's an Avengers movie, or it's not the next superhero movie. It's, yeah.
It's just
its own thing.
It's just Frank Miller at his best, I would say.
Or his worst.
Or I guess my final thoughts on it are, definitely watch this with some friends and just laugh your butts off, because this movie is, as Sam Jacks would say, just plain damn weird.
I could agree.
I would give it 3 out of 5 stars.
Sure.
3 out of 5 stars, yeah.
I can agree with that, I guess. It made me laugh quite a bit.
So that'll be it for this episode of Raunchy Reviews. We're not sure what movie we're going to be reviewing next, but it'll be funny. It'll be funny, I think.
Or it will be so laughably bad. Okay.
Remember to like the video or dislike it if you didn't. And remember to comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what movies you guys want to see me and my brother review. Remember to hit that subscribe button, because that subscribe button will be waiting for everybody. And we'll see you next time. Deuces.
Peace. I think we should just show my thumb off. Just be like, I crushed my thumb at work.
No, we're not doing
just
that.
Just like, we'll cut black at the end. And then if they stay, we'll just be like a close-up in on me. I crushed my thumb at work.
I think I'm just going to put this conversation at the end.